Hello. For Highbrow Magazine, I'm Forrest Hartman. It's shaping up to be an incredible year for movie musicals. Hamilton superstar Lin-Manuel Miranda has played a role in two great theater-to-film adaptations, Tick, Tick, Boom, available on Netflix, and In the Heights, streaming now on HBO Max. If you haven't seen them, change that as soon as possible. Now, Steven Spielberg has joined the party for a loving film adaptation of West Side Story. Interestingly, we already had a great film adaptation of that musical, which features a score by Leonard Bernstein and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. Broadway choreographer Jerome Robbins and director Robert Wise famously brought the work to theaters in 1961, and that's a film any serious movie historian should add to their viewing list. But so is Spielberg's. Some will see Spielberg's take on West Side Story as a remake of that 1961 movie. Others, like me, see it as an updated adaptation of the original stage show. Ultimately, though, none of that matters. What's important is that the film is great. This new West Side Story is exactly what one would expect when a terrific filmmaker gets handed an equally terrific piece of musical theater and goes to work. Spielberg maintains the integrity of the stage show while opening things up and creating a distinctly cinematic experience. For the few who don't already know, West Side Story is a reimagined version of William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, set in New York City during the 1950s. Rather than Montagues and Capulets, the story features a face-off between rival ethnic street gangs, the White Jets, and Puerto Rican Sharks. Of course, the action still centers on star-crossed lovers. This time it's Tony, a former Jet who falls for Maria, sister of the Sharks' leader, Bernardo. As with stage versions of the musical, the romance develops too quickly and there's so much going on that characters aren't as well developed as one might like. But if you love Broadway musicals, you'll overlook all that because the music is absolutely wonderful and Spielberg's reading is gorgeous to look at. What viewers get is a film with the charm and warmth of a golden age movie musical, but the technical standards of a 21st century blockbuster. For Tony, Spielberg turned to Ansel Elgort, and for Maria, he introduces us to Rachel Zegler. Both are wonderful.
Tonight, tonight, it all began tonight. I saw you and the world went away. Tonight, tonight, there's only you tonight.
Unfortunately, I don't have time to list everyone in the cast, so I'll just say that there aren't really any weak links. I do need to mention, however, that the great Rita Moreno appears as Valentina.
I want to be with you forever.
You don't want to start maybe with I'd like to take you out to coffee?
No. Come on.
I want to take you to a shop full of nuts for a cream cheese sandwich on a raisin bread.
This ain't casual like that.
Whoa. I want to be with you forever. Quiero estar contigo para siempre.
She's terrific, but this is most noteworthy because she played Anita in the 1961 film. Longtime fans are sure to appreciate this fact, even if younger audiences don't make the connection. One could easily spend longer singing the praises of Spielberg's West Side Story, but there's no need. The film is great. If you were on the fence about seeing it, jump off and head to a theater. The visuals are beautiful, the dance sequences are stunning, the acting is first rate, and the songs are, well, the songs are what you get when Bernstein and Sondheim collaborate. Need I say more? For Highbrow Magazine, I'm Forrest Hartman.